Workflow coaching was created as a way to introduce people and let people practice a set of best practices that have been synthesized over a lot of years about the things that sort of get rid of residue and allow us to get more done with less psychic effort, if you will, as well as less physical effort. And basically, it was a way to create a two-day format where we could both gather together all the incomplete backlogs that people had in terms of agreements and commitments, be able to put that in a way and be able to coach people in a way to get through that, make the decisions that they've usually been avoiding about a lot of that stuff, and park the results of that thinking into a good, intact, customized system for them that they can then maintain that and then keep all their agreements and their renegotiating abilities about that externalized, keep it current to keep up with the kind of volume that's coming at them. Basically, to free up their psyche so that they can focus on what they really want to focus on and yet not lose details that would then start to suck energy out of their brain if they didn't manage that. In a way, what the workflow coaching process does is it lets people, gives them an experience of what it's like to appropriately engage with their own commitments with themselves, be able to see that whole game, renegotiate it rapidly, and then have a lot more choices so that they're more proactive, more in the driver's seat about how they focus themselves as they go through the day. And also improves tremendously their ability to deal with surprise. Because that's a lot of what the world is throwing at us these days is, okay, I got nice and organized or I'm focused, but then something happened I didn't expect. And it blew it up. And so our system is really a no system system. It's a process about how do I now deal with whatever's got my attention so that it gets off my mind and gets done.